Goodbye, England's rose. May you ever grow in our hearts. You are the grace that placed yourselves where lives were torn apart. You called out to our country and you whispered to those in pain. Now you belong to heaven and the stars spell out your name. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind.
Specifically, we need you to help write comedy for the show.
Oh.
Like situational comp, like a like, setup or a sketch or a joke that we would do.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I write funny poems.
Well, let's hear one of those then.
A dog who looked like Abraham Lincoln fucked my brother one night when we were all on acid at Kit's house. I'm convinced of this. Okay, maybe actual copulation didn't take place, but it sure looked like fucking to me. And my brother's terror was real. Something the way he vibrated and shouted, I'm scared, told me he was frightened. And wouldn't you be frightened?
Yeah.
If a 200-pound Great Dane with bucket-sized jowls of saliva dry-humped you while you writhed in the throes of psychedelia?
Was that part of the wouldn't poem, you? Or is that a question?
That was the poem.
Here's me, Adam Friedland, host of The Adam Friedland Show. I'm in Manhattan, New York at our Global Operations HQ, listening to a weird guy reciting a poem. How the hell did I get here? Views are in and the fans have spoken. The Adam Friedland Show is a hit. For the first time in my life, I feel better than good. I feel like a baller. I'm finally reaching my potential as a comedian, and even as a man. And my best bud Nick is finally starting to pull his own weight. Between learning camera tricks, paying the rent, and helping out with the jokes, I'm getting over my nagging fear that he's been holding me back. Anyway, here's me going to work. I take so much inspo from the greatest city in the world, NYC, with its towering skyscrapers and beautiful models. In a place like this, anything's possible.
It's drugs.
Oh my. That's Nick. Oh no. They're gonna think it was me. They're gonna think it was me. Nick.
It was probably this that did it.
Please pick up.
Oh my God. Please don't be dead. Please don't be dead.
What the fuck is this?
It's me. I just got to the studio. I don't know what's going on. I'm confused. It's a mess. You've been on drugs. You've been on alcohol. There's sex things. Just call me back. I don't care about the show anymore. I just want you to be okay.
Wait a second.
Today is my day. I'm finally free. The Adam Friedland Show belongs to me.
He was holding me back, treating me like a dog. Now I'll write my own monologue. Nick is dead, and that's a shame. Now is my chance for glory and fame. I'm a star, the Adam Friedland Show. And I'm gonna go far, I'm a star. I'm gonna go far, I'm a star.
It was time to write the monologue. I wrote. And I wrote.
It's not bad.
And I wrote. And I wrote. You know what? Maybe it's not me. Maybe it's Nick still holding me back this whole time. Another crumpled up piece of paper. Because I have crazy writer's block.
So I hired an unpaid intern from New York University to help me with the show. Her first order of business? Posting a Craigslist ad. Needed. Executive producer / co-host / best friend for talk show. Parentheses, maybe hot girl. Parentheses, center left politics. If the show was going to go on, I needed a new Nick.
Yes.
What's up, dude? Just over here. Hey, I'm
Eric.
Yeah, nice to meet you. Okay, so I run a talk show, and you saw that in the ad. So
Yeah. Okay.
So yeah, my friend, he has problems with drugs and alcohol, and he recently died. So I'm looking for a new best friend.
Oh my god.
And a producer. So that's kind of
Yeah, I know. I just kind of like I'm looking for work, and like I've been wanting to get into like entertainment type of jobs.
Yeah.
I'm like. Live right by anyways.
Do you have any experience in the entertainment industry, or is there
just from like just from observing from basically like what I'm consuming on TV and consuming via the internet these days?
What kind of stuff are you?
I watch mainly what other people are watching. Like HBO is my go-to essentially, and they like can't do no wrong in my opinion.
Yeah, that's fire.
And but I'll just even like these streaming platforms are making my head hurt. There's so many platforms these days.
Yeah. So yeah, I mean like that's cool. I mean, are you into comedy or like it is a comedy show. So
yeah, I like comedy. I'm mostly a serious person, but I am. Uh-huh. So I'm never, I can be humorous with my friends.
And yeah.
Like,
yeah.
That's when I'm laughing the hardest is when we're doing inside jokes and like, I like drama too, but I don't know. Sometimes I'm scratching my head at how people can be so funny.
Okay. So you don't know it. Like you don't know any jokes or anything.
If all right, well, let's pretend that I'm in front of the Golden Globe. I'm hosting the Golden Globes.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Room full of celebrities.
Okay.
Right.
All right. Yeah. I like that.
And I'm looking out of the audience and I'm saying, you guys make all those movies about criminals.
Mm-hmm.
And you guys make all those movies about being greedy bastards.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you make a movie about yourselves? And drop the bomb there.
Mm-hmm.
And literally they're like, Leonardo DiCaprio's there, Meryl Streep, and they're laughing and just imagining.
So the joke is that instead of making movies about other people, they should make movies about them.
Yeah, because Hollywood is so corrupt.
Yeah.
You know Ricky Gervais, right?
He's like mean to all of them when he's there.
Yeah. That's kind of the stylistically.
Oh, so you're roasting them.
Yeah.
You're like, look at this fucking pedophile. Look at this.
Yeah, exactly.
Bitch. Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. That's kind of cool.
Yeah.
All right. I mean, I'd like maybe like to see more of like your creativity on the fly. Yeah. So maybe you could like make up a lyric of a song that maybe we could do on the show.
Yeah. Can you give me a suggestion?
Like a keyword or like a situation.
God, can you give me a sentence?
I want to look inside.
Yeah.
I want to look inside you.
Yeah.
I want to look inside your soul. Maybe. I mean, it doesn't even have to have the word soul.
Inside your soul. I want to look inside your soul. Why don't you give me no more? Tired of you beating on me. Sucking on me.
Yeah, I mean, is there anything else like from your like life or job experience that you think you're like bringing to the table that maybe might set you apart from other candidates?
They say work hard, play hard, but it's like, and people say that, but I do live that way.
Yeah.
And like, I don't have addiction, but I will drink every night if you want me to. Like,
this is a project that is completely independent of networks. Okay. The fans are giving us money on all this. This is all bought by the fans. Okay.
Yeah.
So they are our bosses. Okay. They're our best friends and our bosses. And we respect each and every one of them. So if you want to go to camera right there, if you want to say something to the fans, or there, right there, that camera, why don't you just go ahead and do that?
All right. So I love people. And I would love to do this job badly.
All right, let's get the next one in. Let's get the next one. All right. Come on. We have a lot of applicants. Hi. Yeah, hug. That's not, you're not actually, you want to tell me a little bit about yourself?
I feel like, I can bring a lot to the table. I'm Indian.
Yeah, that's big. My former co-host, he was a raging racist and
white guy,
closeted homosexual, uh-huh. but also homophobic at the same time.
I have a little of those things just in a different skin.
Exactly. And I love your skin. Let's call a spade a spade. Is that a racist term? Spade is.
Oh, is that?
I don't know.
Yeah, let's call it racist.
Okay, I'm not going to say that anymore.
You can do that around me. I don't care.
Really?
Yeah.
You want to look into camera two over here? If you want to say, give them a message, tell them why you think you'd be the good to be the new Nick.
Guys, I don't know about the others that are on the roster here, but I am Indian. I am an American, a proud American. Proud American. And whatever you want me to do, I'm your man. Whatever you tell me to do in the comments, anywhere, on the blogs.
I don't know about anything.
Anything.
There's some of them are sickos.
I'll fucking.
No, okay. It's fine. All right. I think my friend killed himself with this. So, okay.
Anything.
I've done 6 years of jazz tap.
Okay.
8 of improv.
All right.
Studied at UCB for 6 years. That was 3 years where I was doing jazz tap improv, and then 3 years I was doing just regular straight up heterosexual improv. Then I did Second City.
Uh-huh.
Then I did Third City for 2 years.
Which city is the third city?
Tacoma.
Tacoma, Washington.
Yeah. So you guys have a podcast.
We used to have a podcast. We're trying to make it into a television show.
And it's called Cumtown?
It was called Cumtown. Now it's called The Adam Friedland Show.
When you call something Cumtown?
Yeah.
People are going to think you're gay.
Well, that's kind of the thing. We used to say that, oh, I'm gay and that my dick is small. That's what we would say. We maintained a fan base for the last 6 years who got off on calling me gay, right. Calling me F-slur, calling me a queen, a twink, a gossip, you know, a rent boy. And I would go into my DMs every day and I would see that. And it didn't feel good. And in some ways, I do feel like an honorary member of the community.
Do you, do you want to say the F word now?
Fuck.
The other one.
Say it. Is there like a soft A version you guys do?
You can make it as soft as you want. You can do the hard T if you want.
Oh, the hard T, but that's like the hate one.
It's not hate, it's just love here now.
I'm a faggot. today is my day. I'm finally free. The Adam Friedland Show belongs to me. Nick is dead, and that's a shame. But now is my time for glory and fame. I'm a star, the Adam Friedland Show, and I'm gonna go far. I'm a star, it's the Adam Friedland Show. Yeah, something like that. If you want to just, I don't know, it's a lot of lyrics and stuff.
But no, it's really beautiful.
You felt that?
Yeah.
I was just thinking, because now Nick's gone, I gotta have a new theme song.
I'm like, it's getting my heart going.
Thank
you. It's like, it's emotional, it's resonant.
Thank you.
It just has like all this narrative thrust to it. And
it's about my life.
Yeah. I can tell that it's from the heart.
You want to do like a little.
The Adam Friedland Show belongs to me.
Nick is dead,
and that's no shame, because he didn't know how to play this game. I think you should vote for me, because then you'll have a license to say faggot.
Mm-hmm. Every single one of them. Wow.
Yep.
But not at me, but just in general.
Just in all day.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Okay.
You know you want to.
That, yeah. You know, they're thinking it. You know, that's for sure.
Hey. This is the
Craigslist podcast? Yeah.
Right.
Wow.
So, yeah.
You want to... I don't... There's drugs and I don't know if that's a safe place for the kid.
Oh, sorry, dude. He's fine.
All right. The job is for a co-host and executive producer for my late night talk show that I'm making
right now. It's not remote, right?
No, it's not remote.
Sick.
Okay.
Sick.
Because you're gonna be here, like, we've been here 7 days a week.
Great. For like, the more the better.
Yeah.
Dude. I'm done with.
Yeah.
This okay, so it's just like I'm trying to get back to what I do, you know? Which is like chilling. This looks sick, like,
yeah.
Like,
well, my friend had a relapse on drugs and alcohol,
right,
but,
dude?
Yeah,
hell yes.
But you know, that's I do hell like yes. to party, I guess,
right? That's it for me, dude.
I would
I'm
party.
Just trying to party, but like,
you got
I
this.
Can't. This fucker, dude, this fucking guy is like 24/7, man. He is going, and it's like, enough's enough, bro. I'm done,
you know?
Like, I'm
right.
done. I saw this and I thought, wait a minute, this could get me out. It ain't pussy, but works work. I'll do that.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, maybe there will be some, you could get some off of the,
This is for me, buddy. Okay. I'm sorry, dude. I know this fucking sucks, but like, he's usually mad chill. And like, if I could just throw him in that trash, he loves playing with trash.
Don't, I wouldn't feel comfortable with him in the trash, but,
it's really fine if I just throw him in that trash for 2 seconds so we can do this and like,
How are you? Good. So you're here from Craigslist?
Yes.
Okay, cool. You're applying to be an executive producer of a late night talk show.
Atarashii hosto.
Oh, that's funny. Yeah. Okay. So, I guess like, do you have any experience in show business? Like anything you want to tell me about what you're bringing to the table?
Nani mo nai desu.
Yeah. Was that, is it, Japanese? Or?
Hi.
So, could you maybe tell me a joke or something or?
アルミ缶の上にアルミ缶?
Is that a question or are you asking me a question or okay?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. So is the joke finished or?
Hi.
Okay. All right. I could show you the show a little bit and if you know what the show is, then you can get like a sense of what our vibe is. You know, I guess you don't really need to speak English because like I'm probably going to be the main creative force here. But I don't know. Just tell me. I don't know. I can show you this. Just tell me if you think. Here, it's this. This is like from our last episode. It's me and my friend. All right. We're really excited about our next guest, ladies and gentlemen. It's a Chinese guy. Get the mic. You need me to help you?
Got it. Hey, everybody. Good to see you again.
Yep. Give him a hand, everyone. How about this?
Hey, thanks for having me.
Yeah, thanks for being on the show.
Look, you guys are so, it's a living, folks.
So yeah, what did you think of that?
Chinese guy is funny.
Yeah, the Chinese guy. He's pretending, but to be, he wasn't. Did you think I was good or? Did you think I was good in that or? You like the Chinese guy, but what about?
You are funny.
Our fans are watching right now, so if you want to just say why you think you'd be good at the job, you could just go ahead and tell them. You could do it in Japanese, I guess. Or
頑張って働きます.
Arigato. Thank you.
I'm a subscriber, long-time fan.
Oh, okay. Well, that's kind of setting you apart from pretty much everyone I've spoken to today. So,
for the show, I think it really needs to be the Adam Friedland show. And it's not like, it needs to be bigger than a podcast. It needs to be bigger than comedy.
Yeah.
It doesn't like to just be all about you 24/7, forever. Like, I think we're all living in like the Adam Friedland show.
Yeah. All right. That's interesting.
I see you and I think like, Ezra Miller, but harder, you know, more beautiful, like Shia LaBeouf, but more conceptual, more brilliant. If I say Adam Friedland, I hear words like Kanye here, Basquiat, you know.
Oh, yeah.
New Caravaggio, Leonardo DiCaprio, Leonardo da Vinci.
Uh-huh.
We do. Adam Friedland, you're like the new Warhol, right? But like, you're better than Warhol. You're Warhol, like Warhol for now.
Yeah.
Changing the whole idea of what does it mean to be a human? What is identity?
Mm-hmm.
How do I express myself? What is expression? Like, who
is
Adam?
Yeah.
What does Adam think about this?
That
Where is
good.
Adam? Yeah. Like, I want to make you into a sort of a god, if that sounds like a sort of a kind of living god walking among us.
Yeah, thank you so much. You want to maybe a hug or? Yeah, all right. Okay, thank you so much. All right.
All right, take care.
All right. I thought that was pretty good. I'm looking for a producer, okay? I'm looking for someone that is a doer, okay? Not a talker.
I do.
You do. Yeah.
I do.
And part of the thing that we're trying to do is we're trying to get big celebrities on the show now.
I mean, the best way to get a celeb is to ensnare them.
Uh-huh.
You know, trap them with a kid.
Uh-huh.
You know, maybe a little nose candy, a little something in the room.
Uh-huh. That sounds like producing. You know, that sounds like a good producer, and I like that.
Stop right there. I got a funny story for you.
Okay. Yeah.
Back about 15 years ago, my old man came back from overseas, and he had to go, you know, he had to make the mortgage, so he told my mom that he was going to take a job on an oil rig up in Alaska. So she said, you can't go. You can't leave the kids. He said, I got to go.
Back shots, baby, all day.
Wow. He's blowing.
All he can hear is the sound of silence. He looks up around himself, and he sees everybody staring at him in disgust, and no caribou to be seen.
Oh, no.
And he says, what the hell y'all looking at? Y'all do this every night. And the foreman, old Tex, he goes, man, that's the ugliest fucking caribou I ever seen in my life. That's pretty good, man, huh?
I mean,
that's comedy.
That he saw that he was having sex with an ugly animal.
Oh, yeah, it was an ugly caribou, yeah.
You normally don't know if an animal is ugly.
Exactly.
All right, let's see that. It's been a lot. Hi. Hey, man. You want to come in right here? Yeah. What's up, man? Hi. I'm Adam. Nice to meet you, man.
I'm good.
You want to grab the microphone? Yeah. I don't know where he is, and so I've made the executive decision to replace him, so I've had my assistant put out this Craigslist ad.
So y'all not looking for him?
No, I've called a lot of hospitals and stuff, and but yeah, you know, the show must go on.
Let me ask you a question. How much y'all pay?
Well, it depends.
Because I'm in a bond right now, and I kind of need some cash, so I'm just trying to figure things out.
Well, we can talk about it. I mean, we
Because I don't know if I really want this type of job, like, for myself. Like, I know
the job
it's
does
a
not
good
require
opportunity for you to work with me. But, like, for me, the way I look at it, like, it depends on the numbers, B. Like, it really does.
Okay. Well, this, I mean, we it could be fairly lucrative if you're bringing the right qualities, you know, to the table.
Nah, I'm perfect fit. Don't even trip. But, like, okay, like well, see, for do me, you have... it's, like, it's more of a my decision type of thing. Like, you got to look at your spot. Like, I got a lot of work to do here. There's a lot of
we have a lot. Yeah. There's cleaning up to do. Well, I mean, so I have to. I don't have
how much y'all pay.
Okay. Well, I don't have the passwords to the money per se right now.
That sounds crazy.
And we don't know how to get into those accounts. So what I will potentially need you to do is to go to his family and say, do you know your son's password to the Patreon?
Hold up. You want me to
I'm not telling you what to do per se, but if you wanted to maybe, you know,
make them give me the passwords?
You know, if you wanted to.
You think they pussy?
I have met them once or twice, but yeah, I think if you did this thing that you came up with, this thing of
hold up, you tricking me with the words, B.
Okay.
I came up with
nothing.
Following up on a Craigslist ad.
Were you to find the passwords to the Patreon and the Chase banking account, that would probably put you in good running. Maybe you could tell me what your favorite joke is.
Nah, I mean, in the culture that we live in today, my jokes, they're definitely on the cutting edge.
Oh, that's what we do. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah. That's totally, that'll work.
That'll work. Yo, thank y'all for having me.
Yeah.
Such a great night out tonight.
That's good.
It's a wonderful town to be in Chicago.
Yeah, we're in Chicago. Yeah, that's right.
That just pops in my head.
I like that, yeah.
It's
like,
a wonderful town to be in Chicago. Yeah? It's my first time in Chicago.
Yeah, welcome.
And it's going to be my last time in Chicago. it's the winter, and it's really cold. That's why they call it the Windy City.
The fans of the show are the ones that pay for the show. They pay for our financing.
So you have people that
pay
for
everything you see. All this mess, everything you see, they pay for everything.
There's
so
cocaine on the floor.
No, it's not.
They pay for that.
Well, indirectly, yes.
There's a used condom. They pay for the.
Well, I mean, why don't you look in the camera too?
Hey.
And if you want this job, I want you to look into their souls. I want you to look into these are the people we respect the most, and tell them why you deserve to have this job.
Yo.
Why you want it?
My name is Derek. I deserve this job because it's hard. It's hard out here. I want to be on TV ASAP. Put a nigga like me in a mansion.
There's problem? You guys are having problems?
What? What are you talking about?
Well, you want this job. Are you guys?
Yeah, no, not really. I was just, you know.
But aren't you and Dasha aren't separating or anything?
No, we're all good. She's right here.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Hey. Crazy you're here. Yeah.
You know, we heard you needed some help, so.
Thanks. I really appreciate it.
I don't know. How hard could it be?
it's really hard.
Yeah. I mean, if we can do it. You know, I have a family now, so.
Oh, you need a second job.
Get yet another income.
So Nick's dad?
I don't know. He had a relapse on drugs and alcohol. But, you know, everything else pretty good. How's your thing going?
Good.
You guys? Yeah.
Oh, yeah, really good.
You guys are racist or something? What's going on there?
Yeah, we're right-wing now.
Right-wing.
First, we were in socialists, and now we're...
That's cool. We're center-left, actually.
That's cool, I guess.
We just, you know, we're pretty busy, actually. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, I wasn't interested either, actually.
We've had a lot of growth, too.
Yeah. So we got a lot going on.
Yeah. Well, so do I. It's... Okay, so...
But good luck.
Yeah, okay. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Okay.
Yeah, bye.
Okay, we'll see you in hell.
Yeah, bye. Yeah, thank you. Oh. Yo! What's up, dude? Mike, good to see you, man. You want to take a seat? Don't be a weirdo. Come on. As you saw on Craigslist, Nick's gone. I need to replace him, and they won't need like a period where they get adjust to you or get to know you because you were on the show 2 weeks ago.
Sorry, I was just in the neighborhood. I took the fucking bathroom key the last time I was here.
In the Mike, yeah.
Sorry about that. So I want to return it. Sorry, it's in two parts.
You took the bathroom?
Yeah, sorry, it was an accident. I hope you haven't had to use it or anything.
I've been shitting in the women's restroom.
Yeah, sorry, man. I kind of got a bus out, actually, but yeah, it was good hanging out. And
chill.
Hopefully let's chill soon, man.
Yeah, let's chill. All right. Yeah, I'll see you. I got interviews, but okay. All right, peace, dude. Hey, right here, yeah. Hey, I'm Adam.
Okay.
So you saw the ad on Craigslist?
I did.
Yeah.
I did.
Yeah, okay.
I think I'd be a good co-host.
Yeah, okay, cool. Are you in show business or have you?
No.
No. So what? Yeah, so you just saw the...
Saw the ad.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, and it's Saturday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you know any, like, jokes? Could you...
Yeah.
Yeah. Wait, maybe you could tell me, like, what your favorite joke or something? Yeah.
Isn't a co-host, doesn't he just laugh at your funny thing? But aren't you the one who's supposed to be funny?
Yeah, but it doesn't really work that way with us, actually. The co-host was actually probably one of the funniest people on Earth, perhaps.
Oh.
Yeah.
If you were a drug, what kind of drug would you be?
I've never done drugs.
Yeah. See, then there would be an awkward pause.
Mm-hmm.
I would have to say something clever.
Yeah. So, like, what would you say?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe I wouldn't be a good co-host.
We need, like, we need you to help write comedy for the show.
Oh.
Like situational comp, like a setup or a sketch or a joke that we would do.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
I write funny poems.
Well, let's hear one of those, then.
A dog who looked like Abraham Lincoln fucked my brother one night when we were all on acid at Kit's house. I'm convinced of this. Okay, maybe actual copulation didn't take place, but it sure looked like fucking to me. And my brother's terror was real. Something the way he vibrated and shouted, I'm scared, told me he was frightened. And wouldn't you be frightened?
Yeah.
If a 200-pound Great Dane with bucket-sized jowls of saliva dry-humped you while you writhed in the throes of psychedelia?
Was that part of the poem, or is that a question?
That was the poem. Uptown, downtown, everybody's getting down. Say uptown, say downtown. Well, I missed my bus. I know I'm late. Gotta do something I know I hate. Gotta walk to work, 15 blocks, already got a hole in my socks. Go ahead and laugh, that's okay, cause what I really wanna say is got bad feet, my corns hurt, top it off, I'm late for work.
You know, to know a man, you need to really look at him in the eyes. I was wondering if I could just look at you in the eyes. Yeah, if I could. Thank you so much. What? Okay. So basically, here's the deal. Nick, I don't know where he is. I don't know if he's dead or alive, but I'm looking for... It's a lot of water.
Yeah. I'm sorry, Ed.
Yeah.
They didn't give us any water on the bus, so...
Cool. So you're a fan of Come Town, the Adam Friedland Show?
Yes.
Okay, cool. Well, it's nice to see a woman actually acting like this.
I'm not a woman yet. I'm a girl.
Oh.
Adam, I'm 14.
Well, then, okay, I don't know if you'd be good for the
thing. No, I think I'd be good.
Do you know any jokes or anything? Or maybe to camera one, you can do a joke.
What would a Jewish Santa Claus do when delivering presents?
Mm-hmm.
Put a pay meter on the roof.
That's funny.
It was funny.
It's anti-Semitic. It's funny. So.
Then laugh. I implore you to laugh.
Implore. That's a good word. It'll be a good word on your SATs.
They taught me that at LIDS.
At LIDS, you learned that.
The manager said, "I implore you to let me put my hand on the small of your back during break."
Okay.
I have more jokes.
Okay, let's hear another one.
They should just call Cinnabon a fat faggot treat. Yeah, I'll get the one with the hot white cum on it. Dude, I don't care.
Okay. All right. Maybe that's one for the old show.
Okay, another one. Come to the cabaret! Thank you so much for this really opportunity. At the Adam Friedland Show, I will work hard for what I want every single day. I will come in here looking good around the office to boost morale. I will come in here smiling, happy, tap dancing every day, always ready to bring jokes of any sort of variety. Blue humor, crude humor, sexual humor, innuendo, pun, or otherwise.
I think you need to slow down, and I think you need to let yourself grow a little bit.
So you're saying come back in 4 years?
4.5 years.
Good, I'll be marinated enough for you.
I don't know why marinated, but okay. But thank you so much for your time. It was nice to meet you. And can you make sure she gets to the bus, okay? And that the door is closed? Okay, all right, that's a long handshake. Okay, can you make sure that she gets to the bus and the door is closed and it's going to Boston?
I had to face facts. The interviews were a disaster. I found myself surrounded by clout chasers and sycophants. And to make matters worse, a child tried to molest me. There were clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right, and here I was, stuck in the center left, without my best bud, Nick. Not even a trip to my favorite place in New York City, the Wizarding World of Harry Potter store on 22nd and Broadway, could cheer me up. I was beginning to move from the denial stage to the depression stage of grief. I missed Nick. I fucking missed him.
No!
Despite the invaluable hands-on job experience I was providing her with, my unpaid intern quit. I had no jokes, no ideas, and I still hadn't done my monologue. I had to come up with something fast. The show had to go on.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Adam Friedland Show. I'm your host, Adam Friedland. Okay, we got a big one. Big show tonight. We got a great show for you guys tonight. It's going to be good. All right, this is what I got. Okay, a dog who looked like Abraham Lincoln fucked my brother one night when we were all on acid at Kit's house. I'm convinced of this. Okay, maybe actual copulation didn't take place, but it sure looked like fucking to me. It's funny, I guess. And my brother's terror was real. Something about the way he vibrated and shouted, "I'm scared, I'm scared," told me he was frightened. And wouldn't you be frightened? If a 200-pound Great Dane with bucket-sized jowls of saliva dry-humped you while you writhed in the throes of psychedelia? What is this shit? Guys, folks, I know I've acted strong for all of you guys the last 2 months. There have been a lot of changes in my life. And I've acted cool. Like none of it bothered me. I thought when Nick went missing that it was a blessing. That it was my time to step up to the plate. A monkey off my back. A weight off my shoulders. But I learned. I don't think I could do it without him. I guess this is the last episode of the Adam Friedland Show before it even started. Nick?
What's up? Whoa. What happened to all my fucking garbage?
I had some people over. There was a child that tried to molest me. There was a crackhead. There was an Indian guy, a Japanese guy. It was very diverse. It was perhaps
an Indian guy. Is that why it fucking smells like shit in here? Why are you stressing?
Because I thought I lost you.
I was at the gym.
For 3 days? I tried to replace you.
Hey, man, I hate to see you like this.
I'm not doing well.
Well, we'll fix it. What do you need? Tell me what I can do for you.
Listen, man, I just need help with next week's monologue.
I got you.
Just general punch up.
Okay. Well, hit me with it. What's the best joke you got so far?
Okay, there's, so imagine I'm Ricky Gervais.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm hosting the Golden Globes.
Sure.
I'm looking out at all those fake celebrities, you know? And, you know, I'm like, you guys always make movies about corruption and sex and crime and violence. Why don't you make a movie about yourselves, you know?
Yeah. And that's the joke?
I guess. I don't fucking know, man.
Now, are you hosting the Golden Globes, or is this still the monologue?
No, I guess I don't fucking
know. How about, like, Golden Globes? The only Golden Globes I want to see is a big pair of tits covered in piss.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
One good thing happened this weekend. Okay. I came up with a new theme song for the show.
Well, I mean, I
know.
Already wrote a theme song. We have a theme song.
People love it, and people love it, and I love it. But, just give it a chance.
No, I'll hear it. Yeah, sure.
Okay, I'll sing it for you. Okay. All right. Unique New York. Okay. Okay. Today is my day. I'm finally free. The Adam Friedland Show belongs to me. Nick is dead, and that's a shame. But now's my time for glory and fame. I'm a star. You get the idea. I mean, it's just...
It hurt.
I thought you were...
It hurts my feelings, but, I mean, it rhymes.
I thought you were dead. Nick is great.
But he's not here. Having a completely normal time somewhere. He's not relapsing.
Okay, let
me try. He's perfectly fine. Yeah. Stop fucking emailing him. Leave him alone.
You could have responded.
And I never pick up the phone when you call.
You could have responded.
You knew I was out of town.
You knew that I was panicking.
I need my fucking
space. You saw the text. You knew that I was panicking.
And that gives me pleasure in some kind of sick way.
Okay.
I'll deal with it in therapy once we get paid.
As long as you make a real commitment to make a change, that's fine by me. Would you mind doing a piano, writing some music for the new song?
Yeah, okay. I could do that.
It's like we're like collabo.
Yeah.
You want to go to Harry Potter?
No, but I'll take you there.
Thanks, man.
Okay, let's go.
Let's go. It's good to have you back.
It's good to be back, sort of.
The mess with the drugs and the alcohol and the condoms everywhere.
What, here?
Yeah, here.
I don't know.
Who was that?
It was fucking... It looks like Slime did it.
Slime. Slime ball. Hey, buddy, come on. Is he coming to go to work? Is he sleeping? All right, Slimey. Yeah, he's gone, so we're good.